Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be doing a full face of first impressions. And first impressions is sort of stuff that I've never used before, and I'm just going to try it out and wear it for a little while and then tell y'all what I think about it. So let's jump in. Okay, the first thing that we're going to be using is, I got this in the travel size, but it's the Professional by Benefit. And I've seen a lot of people that use this. And I'm just going to take a pea-sized amount on my finger. Kind of reminds me, it looks like some peanut butter. Now we are going to take the Healthy Elixir and, Healthy Elixir. And this is by CoverGirl. And I got the shade Classic Ivory because I'm really, really light, even though it's summertime. And we'll just put that and we'll... Okay, sorry, I'm gonna be looking over here. I can't look into the camera anyway. Okay, so if you can see, this is one coat of all over my face, and you can still see all of my freckles. It don't look like an even coat. Oh no, we're gonna take a little bit more. And we're gonna go over these places. And I can already tell right here in my nose, it's already breaking up and it's just been put on my skin. So and this is a shade Classic Ivory, and off the bottle, if you put it on my skin, it looks like my color, but it's oxidizing, and that means that it's, when the air hits it, it's getting darker. So you can see the shade difference now. Now I'm going to take, I used this in my Wet n Wild video, and I really liked it, but it's the Photo Focus Concealer, and I use this when I don't want to use my Tarte Shape Tape. I don't really hear many people talking about the Wet n Wild foundation. I mean, not the foundation. A lot of people talk about the foundation, but I haven't heard many of them talk about the concealer. Okay, now I'm gonna use my trusty Airspun, and sometimes I mix foundations, that's why it's a little dirty. And what I'll do sometimes is I put the powder on one side so I can bake, but on the other side it's still dampened and dry, and so I'll pat out my creases in my eyes, and then I'll set it with the other side. Okay, so I let this sit for a little while, and then I'll take my e.l.f. fluffy brush and I'll just kind of blend it in everywhere, set the rest of my face. And then I'll also just kind of run my brush over the rest of my face. So you can really see all of my freckles and stuff now. Now I'm going to be using the Milani eyeshadow primer. And I've also used this before, but I thought it was just something kind of affordable that many people could buy. So I just took a little bit on my finger and I put that all over my eyelid, and I use my finger to kind of blend this in, and then I kind of tap it out with my finger. Okay, so now I'm going back in with my Airspun foundation, and I'm using my Wet n Wild. It's just a flat shader brush, and I'm going to dip into my Airspun. I'm gonna set my eyes with it. Okay, now we will be using, I'm really excited to use this because I haven't touched it yet, but we're gonna be using the City Mini Palette, and this is, it's Downtown Sunrise. And as you can tell, it's real pretty. It's Now I'm gonna try to get this open. Oh, these are so pretty. And I just wanna swatch one of the glittery ones. Oh, did y'all see that? This is crazy. Okay, now I'm just gonna swatch one. Y'all, those are gorgeous. Okay, now I'm excited. So, we're gonna take my Sculpt blending brush and we're gonna go in with this neutral shade right here. There's kind of a lot of fallout, but it's affordable, so I can deal with that. Normally what I do is I'll build up my crease, so I'll start with lighter colors and further, like, work darker colors into my crease. Ooh, this is a lot of fallout. Y'all can't see that. Still not as bad as Anastasia, the palette that I reviewed not too long ago, the Subculture. Okay, so next color, we're gonna go to brown. Okay, this isn't that pigmented, but we're gonna make it work. Okay, so now I'm gonna use the Morphe 518 brush and go back in with that brown. And that brown's building up real nicely. Kinda like to tap it off. Okay, now I'm gonna take the M441 brush and I'm gonna blend out those edges. And we're gonna take the Real Techniques 203 brush and we're gonna go in that brown one more time. And I'm just gonna pack it on this outer V. We're gonna take the Morphe 441 brush again. Blend those edges out. We are going to take this one of the Amazon brushes again. I always look for the name. We're gonna take this peach pinky color. I'm so excited to use this. That's so pretty. Did y'all see that? That's pigmented. I'm shook. Do y'all see this? Okay, now there is some fallout, but this is from the drugstore and you can work around that. Okay, so I think this color is really pretty by itself, but I'm gonna spray some Milani to make it last on it just to see what it'll do for me. And I kinda like to blow it dry sometimes. Oh, that's so pretty still. Did y'all see this? I wish I had a really good camera. This is gorgeous. Okay. I'm telling y'all, that's crazy. You don't find many eyeshadows like that at the drugstore. Okay, so I'm gonna take my Sephora Pro Blending Tapered Brush. This is the 19. I'm just gonna tap in there. And blend this one more time so that way you have nice clean edges. Now for the lower lash line, I'm going to use this Real Techniques base shadow brush, but it's really like a blending brush, and I'm going to go back in with this cream color, and I'll run it across my waterline. this color is really nothing to my eye shade. If I was like a deeper skin tone, you'd be able to see it. But now I'm going to take this Royal and Lane Nickel. I'm using the crease and smudge side with a brown. And I'm really going to get super close to my waterline. I keep closing this like I'm done. Now we're going to take my Royal and Lane Nickel Smoky Eye Brush. And this, I use it for highlight. And I'm going to take this shade right here. Go in. Put it right here on this inner corner. Maybelline's stepping up the game. Do y'all see? I'm going to need a little bit more. That's crazy. Okay, now I'm going to use the little kitty brush that I own. And I'm going to go back in with this one. But you can kind of use any brush. I use this to get right here in the highlight. Do y'all see? And I'm going to use this blending brush, my Scone one, and kind of diffuse that just a little bit. There we go. That's it for the eyeshadow look. Now we're going to use something that's not that new, but is sort of new. I'm going to use the Hoola bronzer. I'm going to try to get my big fluffy brush in there. I got this brush at Claire's. Just because I'm real pale and I need to be a little bit tanner. And see, what I do is I go around the out of my side of my face and I go right here in my cheekbones, and then sometimes I'll kind of bring it down my neck. Here we go. Okay, and another new thing is I finally got a Wet n Wild blush. And this is the color Pearlescent Pink. And I'm going to use my Luxie 660 airbrush. I'm going to tap in there. It just gives a really pretty flush color. Looks like a clown, but it's okay because it's pretty. Okay, last but certainly not least, and the thing I'm most happy about, I got a new over highlighter, and if y'all can see, it's really pretty. And we're gonna use my Morphe 501 brush, and I don't really want to swirl it because I don't want to get the colors all messed up, so we're just gonna use this color right here. Do y'all say that? You just can't beat it. I just love highlighter. Do y'all say that? Now I like to put it on my nose, down the bridge, and my Cupid's bow. I'm going to just come back. I'm just going to have eyeliner on because I have a new mascara and a new lipstick. So I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back and I just applied eyeliner. And I just like doing that off camera because it kind of takes me a while. But now we will be talking about something I've never tried before. And I only got the sample size because stuff's a little too expensive to be buying the full size for if you don't like it. Let's be honest. I got the roller lash by Benefit. And this is kind of what the line looks like, and it's kind of makes me scared. We're just going to try it out. The spikes on it are definitely a lot longer than they look, and they poke me in the eye. But it's doing a good job at separating my lashes, and they look really, really full and long. This might be a win. Y'all, my eyelashes look so long. This is crazy. Alright, now we're going to try bottom. Okay, not that way. Oh, wait. We have one more new thing. And I got the inflatable paints, and it'll kind of go with today's eye look. And I've been hearing about this a lot. So this is the color Spicy Blush. I'm going to try this out also. Y'all, I'm loving this color. And I love the applicator, how it has that kind of like an indention where it fits on your lip. That's nice. I wish y'all knew how pretty this was, like for real. Okay, well, oh my, this is just crazy how pretty this whole makeup look has just turned out for today. But make sure to subscribe to my channel down below. Buy this and this. Leave a comment for what I should do next if y'all have like any ideas or anything. And I think that's it. Bye, guys.